Hi guys, it's Brie. Welcome back to my channel. And today's video is about my career, and I think this is gonna be a great video for people who have the same hobbies or are wondering what I'm going into when I graduate in 4 years. But I love talking about this. I think it's a great idea to talk about this. But yeah, so let's fall into the video. Alright, so you guys are probably wondering, Brie, how did you find out what you wanted to be? Well, I kind of discovered that in a further video, the end of April, I'm going to be talking about it. But baseball is one reason I said I can't play professional baseball, but I could somewhat be a part of it. So I looked and I scanned for anything that I could possibly do in Major League Baseball, and what popped up was athletic training. And I've always loved medicine since I was a little kid. I always loved the medical field, so I always knew it was something that I wanted to go into. And plus I'm very good at biology and stuff like that, like the life cycles and stuff like that. So I'm like very good at that, and I think that that is something that I'm like very progressively good at. But that's why I choose athletic training, and I love this because I get to work with players one-on-one, and you're always taking care of injuries and you know, the player, you know, and you know, you're taking care of their mentality health. So when you're doing it, they're doing it, and plus you get to travel, so you know, that's really cool. And then I'm also double majoring, and I'm doing sports broadcasting / journalism, and you know, the commentators, that's what I want to do. I feel that that is also something that I would be good at. That's why I went into broadcasting this year. And I also have been hidden behind a camera on YouTube. No, I'm kidding. But I have been doing that. But sports broadcasting to me means a lot. I think that I've always wanted to be someone that speaks and has a good personality and gets to travel. And what's really cool is throughout last year, I was a big Tigers fan. If none of you know it, I was. I actually got to meet Simo, which is Craig Monroe. He used to play here for Detroit, but I also got to see him, and that was really cool because that aspect, you get to see so many things of what they're doing, and it was really great. It was amazing, and like knowing them and like getting to know like that. But also I got to meet Brooke Fletcher. Love her, she's amazing, and she does commentary for Detroit Tigers, and then she also does it for Jimmy John's Field, and that's how I met her, with Jimmy John's Field, or I saw her, and I also thought she was like, hi, and you know, she was just had a great personality, and she is someone I look up to no matter what, because she's like the female in broadcasting, and like Detroit broadcasting, and I think that that is really cool. So that is what I'm going into, but I also want to talk about further extending about where I might be going and stuff like that. So athletic training is basically, if you guys don't know, it's taking care of sports related injuries. So football, concussions, broken ankles, you know, stuff like that. So football, they might use them in hockey, I'm not sure, I think they do. I know in baseball they do, athletic trainers. Basketball, I think they do too. I think soccer, tennis, I think they do. I don't know what sports, but I know it's like the major four sports, but have athletic training. But I know mostly baseball and football do. And I think that that is a good reason, like it's a good thing, because I love, like I said, I love medical, but I also love, like, you know, the sports itself. But I just think that this is, like, the new road for me. And I love it. I love everything that it has entailed and all that. But, because it's led to a lot of different aspects of life and, like, pursuing. And, you know, science is my thing. I've always been involved in science, and that, I think that that is always. So, for athletic training, it's going to be really hard. It's going to be a lot of work. It's going to be a lot of life things that I need to learn about. But I think that also with athletic training, you can be an EMT, and I think that's great. You can get a lot with your athletic training degree, and hopefully I do. I would love to work, you know, do stuff like that. And I think that's really cool, because I think a lot of guys go into athletic training, but not a lot of girls. And we have our first ever girl athletic trainer, I think, in San Francisco 49ers, I believe. Don't quote me on that, but yeah, that's definitely someone I look up to. And yeah, so with athletic training, it's a lot of work to see where you can double major, because that's also a thing, but also where you can find a great university that offers athletic training. So I think we have Texas Christian University. I love that, it's in Texas. We have Central Michigan, go Chips. Michigan State, go Spartans, I have a lot. University of Florida, University of Miami, Georgia, I'm trying to remember all, Clemson, I'm trying to remember all of them, because it's just, it's a lot to think about. At the end of the video, I'll make a short little thing, and I'll put it in there of what universities I'm thinking about going to, but it's a lot to think about, because you have to know by your 11th grade year, and that's 3 years away. It was a lot. So, with this, I hopefully will be able to be an athletic trainer and do things athletically, but also sports broadcasting. And I think that sports broadcasting is like commentating stuff. So if you watch the commentating stuff, you can get to know what I'm doing. But I think I'm going to be more in sports broadcasting than I am athletic training. But I will double major. I know I want to do that. I know I want to do these two. So if I double major, this would be nice. I get 2 degrees in one. And there's a lot involved. But I love doing it. I love hands-on stuff. And I love just what sports broadcasting offers. And you get to travel everywhere too. And I think that that is great, but it's also a lot of work. And I can't, like I'm saying, I can't really explain my career, because like I haven't been in it, but I can tell you it is amazing learning about some of the stuff, because I know some stuff. But it is really amazing to know people that will get you through like this and stuff like that. But it's also great because I went to Tiger Fest, so I got to like experience the atmosphere of like the locker rooms and stuff like that. But like also doing a lot more commentating and a lot more stuff, hands-on stuff, and doing a lot of things that most 14-year-olds would not be doing right now and not be worried about. But I was worried about it for the longest time. First I thought I was going to be a nurse, and then I just realized that I would like to do that, but it's not something that I think that I would enjoy for the rest of my life. Then I thought about being a singer, and then I realized how hard that takes a toll on you, and a lot of things that people don't know about the singing industry and the music industry. It's just a lot. Then, when I was in sixth grade, I thought a lot about criminal justice and forensics, being a detective. My mom always asked me, would I be a police officer? And I said, no, I don't think I would. I think that I would want to be like more like a detective and figure out why this person shot that person, or, you know, whatever it may be. But I always wanted to do that. That's something that I think I always wanted to do. But now this is definitely athletic training and sports broadcasting is something that I definitely want to do for the rest of my life. I love baseball. I love all the things involved in baseball, and just to be closer to it is amazing. And I think that there's a journey that is involved with a lot of things, and yeah. So hopefully you like this video. There's going to be more snippet parts at the end to make this video just a little bit longer. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Thanks for watching. Peace. Free.
Why you think they call me ankle bully? That's cause I'm breaking your ankle, boy. Break them and put them all on the floor. My jumper wet as a sprinkler. Nobody's guarding me on this earth. You know it's money like bank alerts. I'm getting high for the temperature. I know your girl want my signature. I know she wanted, I'm all call. I'm always open like Walmart. Remember when they used to sleep on me? Now they not missing alarm clocks. I got them all scared to guard me. Look how they holding their arm fall. I gotta show them the range. They thought I was driving a foreign car. Do they got insurance for ankles? Cause you gon' be using your OnStar. I'm always breaking their ankles. That's why I'm usually an all-star. You never catching me off guard. Why you think I made this sauce song? I'm already cooking them. Soon as I look at them, I go to putting the sauce on. You better take them and lace them. I like to shake them and break them. Straight to the hole, I'ma take them. Already know I'ma make it. Because I'm an ankle bully. You need your ankle brace. Run from the ankle bully. Cause I'm out your ankle breaking.
This video, sorry I put it in, but I got my Easter gift and it's amazing what I got. And I wanted to share it with you guys, so I want to just, it's from inside the batter's box, and it's a really cool company that sends you stuff as a shipment every month. So this month I got a water bottle. It says do the work, no excuses. I got a wristband playbook, which you write down the plays, and that's really helpful for me, and I got some black eye love that some barbecue sunflower seeds, some big league chew bubblegum, some baseball cards. I'm trying to find Cody. What are you? There's Cody Bellinger. That's a card you don't get. And I also got this shirt, so I'm very thankful for this. And yeah, so come back every month to see this unboxing thing. And yeah, hopefully you enjoy.